The Faustian Bargain. Cutting fossil fuels quickly is a Faustian bargain, a big mistake. The ideal solution is to cut out farmed animals quickly, together with a staged reduction in fossil fuel burning. Climate scientist James Hansen described the fossil fuel dilemma as a Faustian bargain. What did he mean by this? Faustus was an alchemist in the Middle Ages who became deeply dissatisfied with the world and intellectual limits, so he sought a deal with the demon Mephistopheles. This bargain gave Faustus all the knowledge and worldly pleasure he wanted, but it condemned his soul to eternal hell. James Hansen first warned us about a Faustian bargain on climate back in 2005. This deal with the devil was that burning fossil fuels releases both carbon dioxide, which causes warming, and also sulfur dioxide, which causes cooling. Sulfur dioxide and the clouds that it creates reflect the sunlight away, working to cool the planet. And this cooling is very strong. This is from the IPCC's fifth assessment. Here are the emissions, carbon dioxide, methane, etc. And this side shows warming, this side cooling. What I want to point out here is that since 1750, the cooling from sulfur dioxide plus the aerosols and clouds it creates has masked or reduced half the warming from carbon dioxide. So when we compare this with methane, we see that since 1750, methane has warmed our planet more than net warming from burning fossil fuels. Who would have thought that? Methane has caused more global warming than burning fossil fuels. And why is this not common knowledge? Now, let's look at how this works over time, also from the IPCC fifth assessment. This graph shows warming or cooling from yearly emissions. Above the line is heating, below is cooling. Carbon dioxide starts warming straight away, increases to maximum warming in about 20 years, and then tails off, and it keeps warming for hundreds of years. The hatched area indicates warming from carbon dioxide. Sulfur dioxide cools strongly at first, then tails off, lasting about 30 years. The hatched area is cooling. Aerosols created by sulfur dioxide have an even stronger cooling impact. When we combine the cooling from sulfur dioxide and aerosols, together with the warming from carbon dioxide, we see that for the first 10 years after the emission, we have cooling, followed by warming. And it looks something like this. So the Faustian bargain is this. If we stop burning fossil fuels, we stop sulfur dioxide emissions, and that will cause more warming. Methane, on the other hand, has no co-emitted cooling emissions to hold it back. And the warming from methane looks like this. It starts warming immediately, reaches a peak in about 10 years, and then tails off. The warming from methane is the hatched area. So if you compare net warming from fossil fuel burning to warming from methane, methane dominates the first two decades, not carbon dioxide. So we can see why a quick move away from fossil fuel burning combined with business as usual, animal agriculture, would be disastrous. It would accelerate global warming. Of course, 20% of methane comes from fossil fuel production, from coal mines and fracking. These fugitive emissions must also be shut down quickly to get the maximum benefit. So Salish Rao of Climate Healers saw this competition between heating and cooling over different timeframes as a systems engineering task. He discovered that the best way to tame our climate is for a quick move to end animal agriculture, the greatest source of methane, together with a phased reduction of fossil fuel burning. This avoids the Faustian bargain, as well as the intense immediate warming from methane. So Rao proposes a quick move towards a plant-based economy, together with a slow progression to a clean energy economy. And the fact that this is not common knowledge shows us that we have a huge blind spot when it comes to animal agriculture. This is the only explanation of why we could have it just so wrong. And it shines a new light on changing light bulbs. That's a joke. So if you support clean energy, then it's even more important to go vegan to avoid a more hostile climate and potential runaway global warming. Those who continue to eat meat are holding us back from a livable world. And for carbon dioxide in the longer term, there's an elegant fix for that. Look for the video on rewilding. That solution is a large-scale, low-cost natural climate fix, one that will naturally follow as a consequence of moving away from farmed animals. Click here for more videos on animal agriculture and climate, and here for the Climate Healers discussion paper.